The turning point in the Veloso case was a last-minute phone call made by President Aquino. Malacañang admits the president broke protocol to save a life. Nadia Trinidad reports.
If the odds were in Mary Jane Veloso's favor this week, this would have been one sign. Leaders of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations were meeting in Malaysia just before the date of her supposed execution, bringing President Aquino face to face with the people who could change Veloso's fate. Under pressure back home to do something to save Veloso, the president met with Indonesian President Joko Widodo on the sidelines of the 26th ASEAN Leaders Summit in Kuala Lumpur. He asked Widodo to grant her clemency. But Widodo, through his foreign minister later that same day, said the Indonesian Attorney General saw no basis in reconsidering the death sentence. Philippine officials hardly slept that Monday night, they said, devising a strategy to save Veloso, a last-ditch effort Aquino shared with reporters at a time when he too was anxious.
Ang interest ng Indonesia is the drug issue. Yeah. So if this person can help uncover this drug syndicate, it is a value to them. We can help, you know, para bang extend her life at the very least. That's the hope.
That was why Aquino was on the edge of his seat waiting for a call in the middle of a press conference in Langkawi, Malaysia. A call to the Indonesian foreign minister to propose turning Veloso into a witness against the drug syndicate that he believes duped her into smuggling drugs into Indonesia.
The president was so adamant in saying we must transmit this to the Indonesia side as fast as we can.
So adamant that Aquino broke protocols by talking directly to the foreign minister.
He's only supposed to be talking to his counterpart there, but that shows you how determined the president was to move that message as fast as possible.
Palace spokesman said Justice Secretary Leila De Lima and Foreign Affairs Chief Albert Del Rosario worked overtime to provide the necessary guidance to the president. De Lima said she sent formal letters to her counterpart, the Attorney General of Indonesia, and the Ministry of Justice and Human Rights, and invoked the Mutual Legal Assistance Treaty among Southeast Asian countries.
It's such a wonderful feeling to be able to save a life. And in such a nick of time, just a nick of time, literally.
And because of that, the president and his cabinet bought time for Mary Jane Veloso, who lives to see another day. Nadia Trinidad, ABS-CBN News.